Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive.
I am recording.
So
yes.
Your kids. You try to. Your kids.
Mother.
Having a good time.
The shooting star leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go, go, go. There's no stopping.
At the beginning of the semester, I auditioned for a few movies. I'd really started to like the idea of acting, being involved in film, theater, and I guess I was talking to Steve about one of my film auditions, and he said, you know, you should try out for Columbinus, and I said, great idea, Steve, and here we are.
What do you love about working on plays?
I like the creativity, the acting aspect of it. I like how you take a play and all the production goes into it, the lighting, the sound, just the crew, everything put in together, a lot of work into the final project, just the whole process from day one to the last day is memorable.
And you're going to continue on, right?
Almost.
Especially because you were one of the main roles in this. How challenging was it, and what experience did you gain from it?
It was really challenging, just like finding the emotion to drive some of the words that he said. I found it easier. The cast was amazing, and it just like, we just helped everyone through. Everyone had, I think, a couple hard things to say, but for the most part, we got through it.
Right. What do you love most about working? What was most unique about doing Columbinus?
I would get physically ill every day because of the emotions. That the tragedy happened, the emotions that would come in, and by the end of the show, I would literally have a sour stomach.
Yeah.
So the difference is not to try to do more, but rather just listen and then respond in each moment, right? That's the key part tomorrow to kind of add in. All right? I'll say this. I think it's a really powerful show. I think it came a long way in the last few days. I think you've all worked really hard. I think you should leave here tonight being really excited because you have a really good show, right? I don't always say that at dress rehearsal, and some of you that have been in shows before know, I sometimes make this face, you got a good show, I think. No, you got a really good show, right? And we should feel really good as we go out of here.
What was, how different was it from being, I guess, more the technical part of a production rather than the... How do I explain it?
Rather than being on stage.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, it was nice. It was nice to see it like progress, like from day one to now. Like the progression was pretty cool, and it was kind of scary at first with the lights. I'm not gonna lie.
being one of the lead characters, was how challenging was it, and what did you gain from the experience?
Well, it was tough to be the bad guy. And I haven't been the bad guy a lot. And especially someone this real and this twisted and evil. It was tough to kind of put that on and stuff.
And what do you like most about working on productions, and what do you like about Columbinus?
Productions in general, I think there's a lot of things. I like the people that I get to
meet and work with and act, and when we do act, I like the energy that we kind of exchange. Like, I feed off of their energy, they feed off of mine. I also like that adrenaline rush before a performance. You know, it's like a feeling, it's almost like a high, like, yeah, I'm gonna do this, and I'm gonna do it well. And I don't know, I guess it's like the equivalent of playing basketball or chess or something like that.
I think 12:30 is a safer. I think 12:30 is a safer time if you can do it. Right? That's just my suggestion. But remember to sign in so we know where you are. Make sure. Does everyone have their cell phone with them?
Yes.
Do you all have Katie's? Do you all have Katie's cell phone number?
Yes.
In your cell phone.
Yes.
Okay. So if there is a problem with a car, gosh forbid, there's something that happens, you can call. Right? If there's a car that breaks down or something, call right away, we will come get you. That's why we have an hour and a half call, not just for, oh, let's come in and play Zip Zap Zop. It's so that if there's a problem, we can come get you. You know what I mean? We'll get you to the theater. We want to know you're okay. So make sure you keep your cell phones charged and are able to contact people or text or get a message here to people. All right? We are at 10:20. It's a good night to go home and rest and sleep well. You've had a hard week, but now enjoy this time, right? Enjoy this time. Take care of yourself. It's going to be a great show.
Thank
all right.
You.
Thank you.
Get out of here. Love you.
Get out of
here.
Love you.
Love you.
Good afternoon.
Tom was utterly still. He stopped and gave me a look I will never forget.
With your bachelor's degree in business on the wall, next to your 3-day certificate in counseling. You're not equipped to handle what's going on.
The alibi?
The getaway vehicle.
My Honda. Ready?
I have been asked by the family of Eric Harris to assist them through the aftermath of the tragic events at Columbine High School.
You all better get up and leave. We're gonna blow up this library.
I miss doing, just being there every day, working with, you know, Tom, Kira, Chelsea, Jacqueline, Zach, Connor, Joey, everyone, and Katie, the stage manager, Steve, who's absolutely phenomenal director. It was just a great experience. I'm gonna miss. Not to put in cheese or anything, but it was a beautiful ride. It was a fantastic ride, and I'm gonna miss working with those guys. And hopefully, in the near future, we'll be working again. So that's all. Signing off. Any way you want.